Hey everybody, Penguin here. I'm going to be doing some movie reviews. This will be my third movie review. Some of the movies are not so recent, like 2016, one of them back to 2014. But I just recently saw it, so I will review it. First, I want to say, it's been cold. We've had a cold snap down here in Georgia that, well, let's say the wind chill the other day was -5 overnight. And it has been, today it's above freezing, it's like 34, but it's been in the 20s at night, gone down into the single digits. So for, hey, for this part of the country, that's cold. Anyway, let's get on with the movies. The first one I want to review is Coco. Now, as usual, I'm going to read the little description that IMDb gives, and then I'll give my review and I'll tell you what everybody thought about it. Coco, aspiring musician Miguel, confronted with his family's ancestral ban on music, enters the land of the dead to find his great-great-grandfather, a legendary singer. This was a Disney Pixar production, and it got good ratings, but I'm not so torn on the ratings because I know this was a children's movie, but there's a lot of relationship with dead people and ghosts and things like that, and I'm not sure what age group this was set out to or what demographic this was supposed to reach out to. But I'm not sure about kids, you know, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years old, that they would even understand it. And the movie, to me, was very predictable. You knew kind of what was going to happen as it happened. But it was a good movie. I mean, I'm not going to tear it completely apart. But IMDb gave it an 8.7 out of 10. Rotten Tomatoes gave it a 97%. And Penguin, I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10. Just for the predictability of it. It might have been higher, but that's just the way I feel. Okay, this is a recent movie. Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. A mother personally challenges the local authorities to solve her daughter's murder when they fail to catch the culprit. This was a pretty good movie. I don't know if this was based on a real-life event or not, but it really, you kind of... At times it seemed like it was slow moving, but while it was slow moving, you were still engaged. And it was, it's really hard to describe, but I think it was a pretty good movie. But it did again have its slow moments, so I think it's worth the watch. Actually, sometimes I do with movies, no matter how good they are, I get bored with them, so I have to watch in two sittings. And this was one. Coco was one I had to watch in two sittings. This one I had to watch in two sittings. IMDb gave it an 8.3 out of 10. Rotten Tomatoes gave it a 93%. And I'm going to give this one as well a 7 out of 10. Okay, I, Tanya. Competitive ice skater Tanya Harding rises amongst the ranks of the U.S. Figure Skating Championships. But her future in the activity is thrown into doubt when her ex-husband intervenes. Anybody that, let's say if you are... I'm going to say 30 years or older, you know what this is about. You've heard of Tanya Harding and Nancy Kerrigan and that whole thing. Now, this was a decent movie, but I kept trying to think of if this was supposed to be a comedy or was it supposed to be a drama. Because there were some funny parts to it and there's some dramatic parts to it. And I'm still not sure what it was supposed to be. But there, I don't think there's any new information that came out of this than we already knew about the incident. Her husband, it's not a spoiler alert, her husband hired somebody to club Nancy Kerrigan and, you know, break her knee or whatever they did, whatever the damage was. And, I mean, that's pretty much the storyline, but it's tried to show how much Tanya knew or didn't know going into the whole thing. And I think that she knew more than she ever said she knew. The Snowman. My wife had been waiting to see this, and she thought, you know, hey, this is going to be a great movie. But my opinion, not so much. Detective Harry Hole investigates the disappearance of a woman whose scarf is found wrapped around an ominous-looking snowman. This was, to me, a very, 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 very long movie. Very dry movie. There really wasn't any excitement leading up to the plot. It was just... I think I sat three settings to watch this one. I mean, I wanted to finish it so I could review for you guys. But to me, it was just a really, really boring movie. And I guess others felt the same way because it got pretty poor ratings. I mean, Rotten Tomatoes gave it a 7%, while IMDb gave it a 5.2 out of 10, and I'm going to give it a 4 out of 10. Because it just didn't capture me. There's no part of the movie that I become involved with. So I'd recommend seeing some other movies versus this one. All right, next we have Jumanji, Welcome to the Jungle. Four teenagers are sucked into a magical video game, and the only way they can escape is to work together to finish the game. If you've seen the first Jumanji, this one is kind of the same but different. It's the same principle of the game and how things come alive in the game, and you have to do things to win, but in this one, they're inside the game. And their characters change into the character that they pick as their player. So their player persona becomes them, or they become their player's persona. And it was kind of interesting. It was a pretty good cast. And having Chris Rock and Kevin Hart, because they kept the momentum going in the movie. I mean, it was a pretty good movie. It's worth seeing. If you're trying to compare it to the original Jumanji with Robin Williams, if you watch it without comparing, you're going to enjoy the movie. You try to compare the two, maybe not so much. Wonder Woman. When a pilot crashes and tells of conflict in the outside world, Diana, an Amazon warrior in training, leaves home to fight a war, discovering her full powers and true destiny. I haven't been a fan of the superhero movies lately. I think Spider-Man Homecoming was just a joke. I think that was just a poor, poor movie. Some of the Supermans have been okay. The Batmans, I think they run the course. And they keep trying to dig up new superheroes. And I knew they were going to come out with a Wonder Woman because in the last one, that all of them were in there, the something, Justice something, she was in there. So they kind of had to do this movie. And I think they did a pretty good job. I really do. I think they did a better job than I thought they would do in this one. Let's see. IMDb gave it a 7.6 out of 10. Rotten Tomatoes a 92%. And I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. It was a good movie, and I stayed enthralled. I did watch this one in one sitting. And I think it was a pretty good movie. Next, we have Father Figures. Upon learning that their mother has been lying to them for years about their allegedly deceased father, the fraternal twin brothers hit the road in order to find him. There were parts of this movie that were funny. And when I say parts, there were a couple one-liners that were funny and a couple scenes that were funny. But all in all, I was disappointed. I was really expecting a very funny movie and watching this. I mean, that's what I was expecting. I don't know what else I was expecting. I mean, you know, Terry Bradshaw played a good part. But I guess a comedy with Glenn Close, just maybe that's where I made my mistake. You know, Owen Wilson has played some good parts, but this just didn't give me what I thought I deserved from watching it. IMDb gave it a 4.9 out of 10. Rotten Tomatoes a 28%, and I'm going to give it a 3.5 out of 10. It was a very, very lackluster movie. Okay, now, I was going to do the review on John Wick, or John Wick Chapter 2. Then I realized I haven't watched John Wick. Now, that's from 2014. So I watched John Wick, and then I watched John Wick Chapter 2, so I didn't see him out of order. And for John Wick, an ex-hitman comes out of retirement to track down the gangsters that took everything from him. That's kind of misleading when you really think about it, because they didn't take everything from him. They took his car, and they killed his dog. And if that's everything, then okay, they did that. It was a very good movie as far as there's a lot of gunfight, a lot of headshots. You could tell that, you know, John Wick is somebody who's focused. When he sets out to do something, he does it. I mean, as they said in the movie, that's who they call when they want to scare the boogeyman. They call him. So anyway, IMDb gave it a 7.3. Rotten Tomatoes 86. And I gave it an 8 out of 10. I thought it was a pretty good movie. It was fast, action-paced, and I'd stay with it the whole way. So on to John Wick Chapter 2. Chapter 2 says, after returning to his criminal underworld to repay a debt, John Wick discovers that a large bounty has been put on his life. And that is true. That's pretty much what happened. I didn't like this one as much as I did the first one. I think it was not as good of a plot, I guess you could say, or script. while it made sense and it traveled, because the movies tie into each other, some of the things they'll talk about that happened in the first movie get pulled into this one. So it's definitely a sequel, but it just didn't live up to what the first one did. And I think a lot of people agreed with that. IMDb gave it a 7.5 out of 10. Rotten Tomatoes gave it an 89. I gave it a 7.5 out of 10. I think that's a fair assessment. Not as good as the first one, but still a good movie in its own. And the last one I'm going to do is Neighbors 2 Sorority Rising. The new next door neighbors turned out to be a sorority, even more debaucherous than the fraternity previously living there. Mac and Kelly team with their former enemy, Teddy, to bring the girls down. You know, I've been becoming a fan of Seth Rogen in some of his movies, and I can't say this one did him much justice. I don't know if they were in too big of a hurry to get the next movie out, but you were just, there are parts of it that really could have been funny, and you're waiting for it to be funny, and they just kill it with the wrong dialect or dialogue and just the wrong body language or something. It had every chance in the world to be funny, but it just didn't get there. I mean, there were a few funny parts, don't get me wrong, but just not as many as it should have been in that movie. The first movie was pretty funny, and I think they tried to make this one funny. It just didn't work out for them. IMDb gave him a 5.7 out of 10, where Rotten Tomatoes gave him a 62%, and I gave him a 6 out of 10. Again, it could have been more, but I mean, it could have been worse, but it could have been better so much more. Well, anyway, on this cold day, that's what I'm going to give you guys for my movie reviews. So stay tuned for the next one where I watch some more, and I'll let you know what I thought of them. So this is Penguin. Be somebody important. Be yourself. Peace out.